made him governor over all Egypt.
That's right.
And his house. God told Abraham, thy seed is going to dwell in the strange land. Where they are being in bondage for 400 years. But God told Abraham, when they come out, they're going to come out with great substance. 100 years, children. They were in bondage. They were subjugated, cried out for 100 years, but God said, just wait. 200 years passed. They cried out to the Lord. God said, just wait. 300 years passed, children. They still cried out to God, but still found themselves in bondage by the reason of their taskmasters. God said, just wait. 430 years passed, and fell on their knees and cried unto God. God said, I heard the cry of my people. I come down to deliver them with a stretched out arm and a mighty hand. God deliver them, but you have to just wait. That David inquired of the Lord. That's the most salient thing that we should get from the scripture. We have to inquire. Don't you move before God. Just wait. Sometimes you try to fix the problem yourself, and you got yourself in that problem. Of the Lord. Well, why do we need to inquire of the Lord? Or why do we need to just wait? First thing is, you really have to understand who God is. If you know He can make a way when there is no way, you just wait. See, the thing about our God is that He didn't just arrive on the scene. He didn't just come by lately. He was there from the beginning. David said, Lord, thou hast been our dwelling place in all generations. Before the mountains were brought forth, or ever thou hast formed the earth and the world, even from everlasting to everlasting. Outside of time.
Yes, sir.
Before time existed, God was present. God is not subjugated to the laws and principles of time. Yeah. When God heard the prayer of Hezekiah, he sent a message back to Isaiah. The Lord had heard him, and he extended your life 15 years. But look what God did. God said, not only that, I'm going to give you a sign. I'm going to get the sun out of Ahaz. Turn it back 10 degrees. Time stopped. It went back. The wind stopped blowing. The leaves on the trees stopped moving. Man was stationary in his position. But my God, who dwells outside of time, bless him. My God moves outside of time. Just watch.
Yes, sir.
So, my mind recalls on Job. How he was in his house. And how he only got bad news. The first messenger came to him. Well, Job, I want you to know that the ox were in the field. And the ass is feeding beside them. And here came the bad of thousands, sinned, they took all your possessions. They killed all your servants. And I alone escaped to tell you. While he was telling Job his news, here came another son. Job, I want you to know that the fire of God came down, burned up the house, burned all the substance. I alone escaped to tell thee. While Job heard the news, here comes another servant. A band, three bands of Sabians came on Chaldeans, and they took all your possessions. Job heard it. But here comes more bad news. The wind from the wilderness blew down the house. All thy servants and your sons are dead. Just. Well, just wait. Well, don't you know that the good things of life are worth the wait? The good things of life are worth the wait. God promised that He would send us a blessing. God promised that He would send us a deliverer. But you have to just wait. I heard the old man Jacob say, "The scepter shall not depart out of Judah. Neither are all people from between his feet till Shiloh comes, and unto him shall the gathering of his people be." Well, Jacob, I heard your prophecy. Your children were in Egypt 400 years, but I don't see the result or manifestation of your prophecy. Well, just wait, because David has to come and talk somewhat about this prophecy.
Salvation.
Lean on the Lord and you will count. You will just wait. If you're waiting for your deliverance, just wait. If you're sick and you need to be healed, just wait. If you're low in sin and need to be redeemed, just wait. Just wait, children, and then you move in Jesus.